Hippolyta, a nuptial hour draws on apace. Four happy days bring in another moon. But oh, methinks how slow this old moon wanes. She lingers my desires, like to a stepdame or a dowager, long withering out a young man's revenue.
4 days shall quickly
steep
themselves in night. And then the moon, like two silver bow, two bands in heaven, shall behold the night of our solemnities.
Go, Philostrate, stir up the Athenian youth to merriment. Awake the pert and nimble spirit of mirth. Turn melancholy forth to funerals. The pale companion is not for our pomp. Hippolyta, I woo thee with my sword, and won thy love doing thee injuries. But I will wed thee in another key, with pomp, with triumph, and with reveling.
Happy be Theseus, our renowned duke.
Excuse me, Theseus, what's the news with thee?
Full of vexation come I, against my child, my daughter Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander, and my gracious duke, this man hath bewitched the bosom of my child. Thou, Lysander, with cunning, thou hast filched my daughter's heart, turned her obedience, which is due to me, to stubborn harshness. Therefore, be it so, she will not hear. Before your grace, consent to marry you to Demetrius, I beg the ancient privilege of act, as she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall either be to this gentleman, or to her death, according to our law.
What say you, Hermia? Be advised, fair maid. Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander.
In himself he is, but in this kind, wanting of your father's voice, the other must be held the worthier.
I would my father look but with my eyes.
Rather your eyes must with his judgment look.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me. I do not know by what power I may bold, nor how I may concern my modesty. In such a presence here to plead my thoughts, but I beseech your grace that I may know the worst that may befall me in this case if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death or to abjure forever the society of men. Therefore, fair Hermia, question your desires, whether if you yield not to your father's choice, you can endure the livery of a nun, for I to be in shady cloister mute. To live a barren sister all your life, chanting faint hymns to the cold, fruitless moon.
So will I grow, so live, so die, my lord, ere I will my virgin pen nun. Unto his lordship, whose son wish you, my soul consents not to give sovereignty.
You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. You marry him?
Scornful Lysander. It's true, he hath my love, and what is mine, my love will render him. And she is mine. And all my right of her, I do estate unto Demetrius.
I am, my lord, as well derived as he, as well possessed. My love is more than his. My fortunes, every way, have fairly ranked, if not with vantage, as Demetrius. And which is more than all these boasts can be? I am beloved of Demetrius Hermia. Why should not I then prosecute my right? Demetrius, all about it, said, made love to Nadar's daughter, Helena. And won her soul, and she, sweet lady dote, the valley dote, dote in idolatry,
Spotted in a constant can.
I must confess that I have heard so much, and Dimitri is thought to have spoke thereof. But being overfull of self-desires, my mind did lose it. But Demetrius, come, and come, Aegeus, I have some private schooling for you both. For you, fair Hermia, look you arm yourself to fit the fancies of your father's will, or else the law of Athens yields you up, which by no means we may extenuate to death or to a vow of single life.
Let us treat Hermia. Yield, Lysander, your praised title to my certain right.